Hi, I'm Josh Kaplan, Senior Program Manager for Azure Analysis Services. In this session, we're going to talk about how you can model complex data into actionable insight with Azure Analysis Services. Azure Analysis Services is built on top of proven technology of SQL Server Analysis Services, which has shipped with the SQL product for many years. It allows you to take all that data that you have hidden away in data warehouses or data marts and model that into a semantic model which encapsulates all your business logic and makes it much friendlier for your business users to come in and query. Now that you have all your business users coming in to query your data, you can also use analysis services to cache that data, so it's very quick for them to access it, and it reduces the load on your underlying data marts. We've taken SQL Server Analysis Services, and we've moved it to the cloud as a fully managed platform as a service within Azure. You can keep your on-premise data sources by connecting to them through a gateway, or you can move to more modern data sources like Azure SQL Data Warehouse or Azure SQL Database. Then you can connect it up to Power BI or other third-party client tools. Let's take a look at how this works. What you see here is an Azure SQL Data Warehouse. And what we've done is we've collected data from thousands of different taxi cabs in New York City, and we've pulled that data into this data warehouse. Now, the data warehouse that you see is optimized for loading that data, transforming that data, not necessarily for querying. If I wanted to open this up for business users to come in and do their own analysis here, first of all, they'd have to know SQL, but they'd also have to know the scheme of the database, how to join the different tables together, how to perform certain calculations. It's not necessarily the most friendly. So with Azure Analysis Services, we can build a semantic model over this data. This is just one example. And same data set, what we did is we pulled in some of those tables and we've transformed them. We've put friendly business names on there. We put friendly column names. We put descriptions on there. And we put calculations in here like miles per trip or number of trips. And we've also put the relationships between the tables. All this is metadata that the user would normally have to know if they were querying against the database directly. But in the semantic model, it's all stored for them. So they can come into tools like Power BI or Excel or other tools, and they can just simply drag and drop and query the data. So if I want to know something as simple as what are the total number of trips in New York City from cabs, I can go and just take trip count and pull that onto the field. And you can see when I pulled that on there, we actually went and ran a query against Azure Analysis Services, and we scanned all the rows in the trip table and returned the results. We scanned over 2 billion rows to get that number. That's New York City, so there's always a lot of trips. But let's look at where in New York those trips are occurring. We'll take our latitude and longitude and add those to the report, and I'll throw revenue on here. So what we did is we just ran a query to figure out where all the trips in New York City are occurring, where we're picking up customers. Each one of those dots represents a trip where a customer was picked up, and the size of the dot represents the revenue that was made for that trip or the fare for that trip. And it's New York, so again, there's lots of trips. But if I'm a cab driver, where is the best place for me to go pick up customers? Where will I get the most customers, and where will I make the most money per trip? So let's look at the most popular pickup locations in New York. I'm going to throw on here the revenue per trip, and we're going to look at the zip codes, and we're going to order this by the number of trips per zip code. Again, we just ran another query against Azure Analysis Services, scanning those 2 billion rows and returning our results very quickly. It's very quick, again, because we're using that cache. The data is loaded into that in-memory cache, and it's not going back to the actual SQL data warehouse. So you can see two zip codes stand out much bigger than others in New York. And you can guess what they are, but you don't necessarily have to guess. You can click them. And when I click on one of these, it'll actually go run additional queries here and here to filter down these other two visuals to just show the data for this bar right here. So you can see the first bar, the first zip code is JFK Airport, which makes sense. And the second one is going to be LaGuardia Airport. There's two airports in New York. You can see people are lots of trips happening there and people lining up on the highways to get their cab. So looking at this, if this was the only data I have, I could see, okay, I can make more money per trip by picking up people at JFK Airport rather than LaGuardia. But since we have a lot of data in here and the queries run very fast, I can ask lots more questions. Let's actually look and see where I can get the most trips from, not just the most revenue. So I'm going to throw our trip count back on here. And I'm going to slice this time by the average trip duration. I'm going to make a little bit of room here. And there's a neat trick in here in Power BI where you can actually change how the visuals interact. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change how this visual interacts with this one. Instead of slicing it, it's actually going to go ahead and filter it. So now when I click on JFK, the bar for JFK, you only see results down here for JFK. And you can see the vast majority of the trips for JFK are between 30 and 45 minutes. There are some there between 15 and 30 minutes. Whereas LaGuardia, way more trips are in that 15 to 30 minute range. Now you make the same revenue per trip almost between the two. I think they have some flat rates there. But you can get a lot more trips from LaGuardia than you can from JFK, just because they're more centrally located and they're usually shorter trips, as the data is showing us. So this is one way that you can explore large amounts of data using Azure Analysis Services. As you've just seen, Azure Analysis Services has all the same benefits as SQL Server Analysis Services, except it's in the cloud as a fully managed platform as a service. Try it out yourself by visiting the following links to learn more. Thank you for watching the session.